You are watching ColdFusion TV.
Hi, welcome to another ColdFusion video. Just 10 years ago, nobody would have ever thought electric vehicles would be in mass production, yet alone change the auto industry. Today, most car manufacturers are thinking about all electric vehicles. Volvo is even saying that they may ditch diesel cars altogether and switch to hybrid and electric cars. What was once a pipe dream and impractical is now a reality in the auto industry. But now, in the latter part of the 2010s, the electric revolution is taking to the skies. Battery tech is just getting good enough to allow several companies to roll out their fully electric aircraft into production. In this quick video, we'll take a look at the state of the art of fixed-wing electric aircraft. Earlier this year, the German firm Siemens just demonstrated a powerful electric aircraft that broke two world records. The first was a speed record. It was the fastest electric aircraft flying at a straight line speed of 340 kilometers an hour. It also broke a climbing record, rising from the ground to 3 kilometers in just over 4 minutes. It was also the first electric aircraft to air tow. The aircraft, an extra 330 LE, was able to do this thanks to a new generation of electric motors from Siemens. Weighing just 50 kilograms, the motor can produce 260 kilowatts, about 5 times the power of comparable aircraft engines, or about as much output as the original Tesla Model S. Siemens plans to use this aircraft as a testbed for developing more in the future. Another company, Pipistrel from Slovenia, is getting ready to ship their fully electric light aircraft, the Alpha Electrode. The Alpha Electrode will be used for flight training purposes and takes 45 minutes to fully charge. The aircraft cuts overall costs of flight training by 70% from fuel savings, and the learning process is exactly the same as its petrol counterparts. Interestingly, every tenth of a second, the system on the aircraft checks the batteries, monitoring their voltage and looking out for any faults. It can electronically disconnect parts of the battery if the system predicts a fault. Upon landing, the propeller turns into a generator, recharging about 5% of the battery. Yet another company, Aero Electric, is launching another all-electric plane called the Sunflyer. It has the same idea of reducing the cost of flight training.
This is really a history-making event. Aero Electric Aircraft Corporation has just unveiled the prototype of its new all-electric Sunflyer plane, which could open up the skies to many more pilots.
By using electricity, they claim that the price goes down from $45 per flight hour down to $1 per flight hour, a real quantum leap. I think this use case makes the most sense for all-electric air travel. Small planes, 1 to 2 passengers, and short trips from 30 minutes to 1.5 hours. It would be good for scenic aerial tours, short charter flights, or pilot training. So what are the advantages and disadvantages of electric propulsion? Well, the advantages are as follows. It's quieter, mechanically more efficient, and doesn't have any direct emissions. The disadvantages is the battery. The bottleneck really is with the battery energy density. It's just not good enough yet for long distance flight. In addition to this, with traditional aircraft, the more fuel you burn, the lighter the craft gets. But with electric aircraft, the batteries are essentially dead weight. But this is where hybrid systems come into play. More so than cars, hybrid planes seem to be the sweet spot for air travel. They can be used for medium distances, flying for about 2 to 4 hours. Airbus is working on a hybrid plane to go into production by 2030. This comes after successfully testing their own fully electric aircraft, dubbed the E-Fan, a project that ran from 2014 to last month. During its testing, the E-Fan was claimed to be the first electric plane to cross the English Channel. With help from Siemens, both Pipistrel and Airbus are in the works of creating hybrid motors, but the hybrid motor from Pipistrel is already in testing phases and makes about 200 kilowatts. So in conclusion, electric aircraft have been in the experimental stages for many decades, but were woefully underpowered and largely had the same issues as electric cars before Tesla got the ball rolling. Now, practical electric aircraft are right around the corner. In the next year or two, they'll be fully in service, but only for short-range, low-passenger-volume situations. But it seems like hybrids aren't far off, and this could open the door to low-emission, mid-range flights with the benefits of both an electric motor and traditional power. And with that, that wraps up the video. This was just a quick look at the state of the art of electric fixed-wing aircraft. Thanks for watching, this has been Dagogo, you've been watching ColdFusion. If you just stumbled across this channel, feel free to subscribe. And I'll catch you again soon for the next video. Cheers, guys. Have a good one.
ColdFusion. It's new thinking.